Hi, I'm Christine. In this video, I'll teach you how and when to use the conditional array function abangMatch. This function is one of our favorites. It allows you to check a value against multiple conditions and then display the appropriate element, icons, text, record field values, or specific UI blocks based on a match. After the match is found, the function will stop evaluating. If there's no match, the function will display a default value. You'll encounter this function when working with status icons or implementing the logic to conditionally display certain parts of the UI. If you previously created a record list or any other UI containing status icons, you might have done so using the if function. While the if function is incredibly robust, it only allows you to return two results. The first result if your comparison is true, and the second if the comparison is false. You can nest if statements to evaluate more complex scenarios, but these can be hard to read, especially if they are written by somebody else. The match function will allow you to benefit from the readability that this function will introduce into your expressions and interfaces. Let's look at examples and understand how this function works. One useful application of the match function is when displaying status icons. For example, in the Acme Automobile app, a maintenance request is tracked with five distinct statuses: requested, scheduled, in progress, delayed, and completed. Using abangMatch, I quickly created this expression that, once added to an interface, will easily handle the dynamic display of status icons. You'll always start with your match expression by defining the value parameter, which will then be evaluated against all conditions in the array. In this instance, the value is the status of maintenance. Using the equals and then parameters, I configured this expression to execute the following logic. If the maintenance status equals requested, then notice that this parameter is used to define the appearance of each icon and related text, display one type of icon. If it equals scheduled, display another type of icon, and so on and so forth. To display text labels, requested, scheduled, and so on, I use the function variable fvbangValue. This function variable is used to reference the value parameter from anywhere within this expression. The equals parameter is used with literal values, like my text statuses. Text values are case sensitive, so make sure that the casing of the value and conditions match. If you can't use literal values, select the whenTrue parameter instead. This parameter allows you to make more complex conditions. You'll see how this works in my next example. For match, you also need to define the default parameter. That's what you want to display if none of your equals or whenTrue parameters match the value parameter. For instance, in this example, I use the placeholder text status pending as my default. Notice how simple and clean this match expression looks. It's easy to create, and it's also easy to understand, especially when you or someone else comes back sometime later and makes improvements and needs to understand the logic of this expression. Match is also very helpful when you want to conditionally display certain parts of the UI. In this interface for a meal delivery app, I am using the match function to dynamically show the appropriate text, a message about the meal currently served, based on the customer's current time. For example, during lunch, the customer should see currently serving lunch until 4 p.m. Or if it's after hours, the message should be currently closed, opens at 6 a.m. Let's see how I use the match function to set up this dynamic messaging. I started by adding a local variable to this interface, localBangMenuItems, to store the information for each meal type, including the start and end times for each meal. These will come in handy when setting up the whenTrue parameters, which will define the three time ranges for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Let's examine the match expression now. Once again, I started by configuring the value parameter. This value should be the current time, since it's what I want to know, whether the current time can be classified as breakfast, lunch, or dinner. To capture this time, I use the now function, converting it to the formatting of my local variable. Using the whenTrue parameters, I define the time ranges for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. As you can see, these are set up using simple comparison between the value, or current time, and the start and end times for a specific meal type. Notice that I am referencing the value in this expression using the function variable fvbangValue. Finally, I use the then parameters to define the dynamic text that will display once the current time is evaluated against all possible options. For example, for breakfast, I entered the text currently serving breakfast until, and then added the time using the local variable. If you scan the rest of this expression, you'll see that the remaining then parameters are configured in the same fashion. At the end, I also added the default text that will display if the current time is outside of the restaurant's regular working hours. Currently closed, opens at 6 a.m. Let's recap what we've learned so far. The match function is used to select a single value from an array of options. It will evaluate until it finds a match to the value parameter. If no match is found, the function will return the default value. You'll commonly use this function with dynamic status icons or when conditionally showing parts of the UI. Because of its clear syntax, the match function will make your expressions cleaner and easier to understand and maintain. To learn more about this function, check out the Appian documentation. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.